Welcome to Christian Brothers High School for the Christian Brothers Purple Wave playoff game against Battleground Academy. The game will start just here in a few minutes, and it will be me, Jonah Jordan, here by myself tonight. James Crone could not be here. This will be a good contest between a 13-14 Battleground Academy and a 23-5 Brothers team. The Brothers are coming off a win against St. Benedict that allowed them to have this home playoff game. They won 63-59 in overtime with Charlie Oswald scoring 23 points, lighting up the Eagles from the three-point line. Had 6 threes in the fourth quarter. Played very well for the Brothers that game. Connor Kelly also played well with 4 threes of his own and 16 points. The Brothers are looking to replicate that here again tonight. I have some keys to the game for you here that we put together. We need good shot selection from the Brothers, so we can't have any bad shots or we need to keep up the rebounding on offense and defense. Just don't allow any offensive rebounds, and make sure to try and go for a little bit of offensive rebounds. The Wildcats are a undersized team, so we should be able to take advantage of that. And keep up the defensive intensity. Just always intense. If you get a big lead, don't let them back into the game. Always stay intense. We have some wrestling news here for you from the state wrestling championships that the Brothers are in. Caleb Baker placed first in his wrestling class, as did Elijah Oliver and Nick Gray. Luke Parrish came in second, as did Brandon Hathaway. So congratulations to the Brothers. I'm glad they can bring home the championship. They definitely worked hard and deserve it. We're going to take a short break here for a few minutes, and I'll come right back to you for the starting line. After the prayer for the starting lineups. All right, we're back here at Christian Brothers High School. We wanted to do a little season recap here for you before we started the prayer. All right, so the Brothers' leading scorers this year has been Josh Boer, along with Jake McDowell, Cody Garbazinski. All three have played very well this season for the Brothers. The Brothers have big man Charlie Oswald, who has committed to CBU, leading in three-point percentage at 44.4. And the Brothers have 2 JV players who have contributed in several games this year, in Brody McLaughlin and Harrison Denica. Both played very well for the JV and have earned some time playing for the Varsity Brothers this year. We have some upcoming events here at CBHS. Our hockey team, who has been playing very well this year, is now tied with Collierville for the final spot in the state tournament, and will be playing Collierville this Thursday evening to advance into the state finals. We also have the Taste of CBHS here, which is just a chance for people to come out and for a $60 ticket and taste some different foods from different places around the Memphis area. The brothers and whoever wins this playoff game will advance to play Father Ryan at Father Ryan next Saturday at 2:00 p.m. This has been a very successful season for the brothers, even though they've suffered 2 losses against bitter rival MUS. Otherwise, very successful. 3-3 in division play and 23-5 overall. I'm sure the brothers would have liked to play better against their rivals, but very successful season overall. And now we'll go back to the game that we're talking about. We have several good players from the BGA side. Brian Dangerfield, their leading scorer and leading center, has played very well throughout the season, averaging over 12 points a game. He's a very good player, and he's probably the focus of the brothers' efforts. And now we're going to go to a prayer for Mr. Freire's in a few minutes, and then we'll give you the starting lineups, and we'll be right back at Christian Brothers Sports Network.
Thank you.
All right, we have the starting five for the Battleground Academy Wildcats. We have number 2, Gavin Shelnut. Number 4, Jordan Tutler. Number 5, Nathan Moran.
Number 20, Brian Dangerfield.
And number 30, Andrew Cowell. And now we have your brother, Christian Brothers Purple Wave starting lineup. Number 4, Jake McDowell. Connor Kelly. Number 22, senior Cody Garbazinski. Number 24, Josh Boer. And number 33, Charlie Oswald. We have 3 CBHS players who made all-conference teams. We had Josh Boer make the all-city conference team. Jake McDowell and Cody Garbazinski both made the second team, with Charlie Oswald getting Cody honorable mention. So the brothers have really come together as a unit and all played well this season. And now we will tip here at CBHS. Charlie Oswald will tip for the brothers, and Brian Dangerfield will tip for the Wildcats, with brothers coming up with the ball. We have Connor Kelly at top at half court looking for somebody to pass to. He throws an entry pass to Cody Garbazinski, who's looking to pass. Gets it to Jake McDowell in the corner, puts up a 3, and he puts it in for the brothers to start the game. It's a great way for the brothers to start out the game with a 3-pointer. Now number 30 has it, and number 20, Brian Dangerfield, has it. Misses the little turnaround jumper, and Connor Kelly gets the rebound and gives it to Josh Boer. Oh, Josh Boer throws it over the head to Connor Kelly, and Brian Dangerfield, oh, it's blocked by Charlie Oswald. The Wildcats had Charlie on a 2-on-1, and Charlie just rose up and blocked it from Dangerfield. Now number 4, Jordan Tuttle, passes to number 30, Andrew Cowell, who gets it to number 2, Gavin Shelnut, who's dribbling at the top of the key, trying to take Jake McDowell into the paint, and Jake McDowell forces him right back out. Now Dangerfield again in the post against Oswald. Oh, gives a nifty pass to number 4, Tuttle. Tutler, I may say. Now Matthew Palmy has trouble getting the inbounds pass. Great, great defense there by the Wildcats to force the 5-second violation. Now Connor Kelly comes back in from Matthew Palmy. Dangerfield receives the inbounds pass and gives. Oh, and he receives it back on the block against Charlie Oswald. He seems to be having trouble with Oswald's athleticism. Oh, and number two, Shelnut rims out a 3. Now Cody Garbazinski dribbling around the 3-point line. Gives it to Oswald and back to Kelly near the half court line. Connor Kelly is setting up the offense and gives it to Garbazinski. Back to McDowell, who already has 3 points. Ooh, good pass to Oswald, who can't finish the easy layup in traffic. Dangerfield with the rebound and the give to
Moran. Oh, puts in a nifty lay-in. And now Connor Kelly seems to have cut his lip, and they're forcing him to go out of the game. Matthew Palmy will come out with him, or come in for him. Matthew Palmy inbounding the ball. The Wildcats have a very effective press, it seems. Already forced the Brothers to an inbounds 5-second violation. Garbazinski receives the inbounds pass and will bring it up. Gives it to Palmy. Looking for somebody to pass it to. Gives it to Oswald. Pump fakes. Back to McDowell, back then to Boer. Boer gives it to Garbazinski on the low post. He's forced to see. Oh, good move. Oh, they called traveling. The Brothers trail 4-3 with 5:20 left in the first quarter. Turnovers are killing the Brothers right now. Cutler throws it inside to Cowell, who receives it off the tip. And oh, and he throws it away to Palmy. Oh, Palmy needed to pay attention behind him, and Tutler just poked it right out. Connor Kelly seems to have gotten the blood out of his mouth, and Matthew Palmy will come in for him. Or he comes in for Matthew Palmy. Oh, Cody Garbazinski will spot up for a mid-range J, and he puts it in. Great pass by Connor Kelly off the inbounds. Shelnut will, guarded by McGowell, will try and get into the lane. And he looks for somebody to pass to. He'll give it to Tutler, who puts up the contested layup and misses. Oswald with the rebound. Connor Kelly throws it up to McGowell, who throws it in. Oh, and Oswald lost it. Moran is dribbling up the court, takes contested jump shot over Cody Garbazinski, misses. Connor Kelly with the rebound. Josh Boer has it at the three-point line. Pick from Charlie Oswald, throws it to Connor Kelly for three, and he puts it in. Connor Kelly shooting very well from three these past two games. Seems to have found his stroke after struggling earlier in the season. Cody Garbazinski guarding Moran, who throws it to Tutler. Moran is setting up the Wildcat offense. Moran looking for somebody to pass it to, taking all the time he wants. Little backdoor pass to Shelnut, and he throws to Dangerfield, who is blocked, and now Boer's bringing it up the court for a little contested layup. Oh, and he misses it. Left it short. Shelnut's bringing it up the floor. Throws it inside to Dangerfield. Oh, and Cody Garbazinski knocked it away. Good defensive awareness from Garbazinski to knock the ball away. We have some subs for the Wildcats. Number 32, Moran will come in. Number 14, Brown. Number 22, Mayberry. And number 24, Webster have all entered the game. Oh, and Brown threw it out of bounds. Brothers basketball. Kobe Jarzynski receives the inbounds pass from Connor Kelly and will bring it up to four. Josh Brewer's driving into the lane. Oh, he found a little up and under, and he put it in. The Brothers are leading 10-4 with 2 minutes, 50 seconds left in the first period. Now Webster will throw it into number 32, Moran, and it is stripped by Jake McDowell. The Brothers playing very tight defense. Josh Boer will spot up for three, and oh, he barely misses it. McDowell will be called for a foul. Now the Wildcats will be bringing it up the floor. Brown will be controlling their offense as he gives it. Oh, the very good ball movement from BGA as Mayberry throws it in to number 54 Taylor. Number 54 Taylor. Oh, he loses it. Brown is again running the offense as he recovered the loose ball off the Brown bobble. Gives it to number 22. Mayberry, who gets it out to Webster, throws it to Brown. Brown will take Connor Kelly into the paint. Oh, and he throws it out to Moran. Taylor throws it. Oh, nifty pass into Mayberry, and he missed the layup. Boer with the rebound. He has McDowell out in front of him. Just couldn't get it to him. Goes in for the lay-in, and he misses it. Josh Boer is having a little bit of trouble here finding his scoring opportunities as Connor Kelly fouls number 14, Brown, on the fast break. Two shots for Brown. Misses the first as number 2, Shelnut, will come back into the game for number 32, Moran. And Brown puts the next one in. Brown will come out of the game, as will Taylor, as Dangerfield and Tutler will re-enter. It is 10-5, Brothers, with 1 minute and 25 seconds left on the clock. Connor Kelly having a little bit of trouble throwing it in on this press from the Wildcats. Garbazinski throws it right back to Kelly. Oh, Kelly pulling some nifty moves there. Throws a pass in the corner. Jake McGowell, who's already made 1-3. Oh, he barely missed that second one. Oh, as Mayberry just put in a 3 from the corner off a great pass from number 5, Moran. Connor Kelly's bringing the ball up to 4, and he bounced it off his foot. Moran was laying on the ground and tried to start dribbling and get up after them. That's travel, folks. Tutler will enter the game for Webster. The Brothers are leading 10-8 with 45 seconds left in this half. As Robbie Young has entered the game. Young got the ball from Kelly. Throws it right back to Kelly. Kelly bringing the ball up the floor, running the point guard position very effectively for the Brothers. Boer penetrates the lane. Throws a great pass to McDowell, who is fouled by Dangerfield. He'll get 2 shots, 33 seconds left in this first period. Matthew Palmy is set to enter the game for Connor Kelly. McGowell makes the first free throw. He is a 65% free throw shooter on the season. And he misses the second. Dangerfield with the rebound. Moran is bringing the ball up the floor for the Wildcats. Gives it to Mayberry, who throws it to Cowell. Cowell gives it to Moran, who throws it into Dangerfield, who loses the ball. Brothers basketball. There's 16 seconds left in this half as Cody Garbazinski receives the inbounds pass and will bring it up on Mayberry. Cody Garbazinski gives it to Robbie Young, who dribbles, pulls up for a little mid-range jumper. Ooh, misses badly. And it will be Wildcats basketball with 3 seconds left. Moran gets the ball. 3 seconds left. Takes the length of the floor, takes a three, and misses. Great defense there by the brothers. A good quarter. Little few too many turnovers, but the brother, I'm sure they'll pick it up. Connor Kelly will re-enter the game for the brothers, and we'll take a short break. Come back to you here as the second quarter begins. We are back here at Christian Brothers Sports Network as the brothers lead the Battleground Academy Wildcats. Number 15, Cleveland, has entered the game for Battleground Academy as Cal runs the show at the top of the key. Oh, errant pass from Cleveland. And Shelnut now has it at the top of the key and drives on Jake McDowell. Brothers wanted to travel there, and now number 12 has it. Up to Cowell for three, and he puts it in. Brothers had a few defensive laps there on defense as Cody Garbazinski brings the ball up the court. Charlie Oswald now controlling the ball, looking for somebody to pass it to. As Pat finally gets it to Josh Brewer, Josh Brewer drives the lane, splits two defenders, and puts up a layup. Josh Brewer is having the toughest time finding his stroke as he is fouled going up for the rebound. Right now on the floor for the Battleground Academy Wildcats is Morris Herman, number 12. Number 24, Terrell Webster. Number 30, Andrew Cowell. Number 2, Shelnut. And number 4, Tutler. As Connor Kelly puts a little runner, baseline runner up, and it barely misses. The brothers struggling to put the ball in the hoop this second quarter as they're 0-2. Shelnut gets it to Cowell, who's had the hot hand for the Wildcats, throws it out to number 12. Back to Cowell, who drives on Charlie Oswald, and it's fouled. Cowell will go for the line for two. Nathan Moran will enter the game for number 2, Gavin Shelnut. As Cowell misses both free throws for the Wildcats. As Cody Garbazinski throws it to Connor Kelly, who's bringing the ball up the floor. Josh Brewer throws a little pass to Cody Garbazinski, who forces a turnaround. Jake McGowell forces a jump ball with Webster, who has had the rebound above his head. And it's brothers basketball. Connor Kelly will inbound to Charlie Oswald, who gives Cody Garbazinski. And he jumped the pass. Shouldn't do that as he traveled. Could not get the ball off in time. Number 20, Dangerfield, and number 2, Shelnut, will re-enter the game. Dangerfield will inbound to number 5, Moran. As Moran will run the point guard for the Wildcats. Tutler gives it to Webster. And to Dangerfield at the top of the key. Oh, and Shelnut will take a deep three as he puts it in over the brothers' defense. Connor Kelly's bringing the ball up the floor, having a little trouble with this press. Josh Brewer is fouled at the top of the key by number 5, Moran. Connor Kelly will inbound. Oh, throws it to Jake McGowell, who is blocked, but Carly Oswald with a nice offensive rebound in the putback. Moran will try and penetrate on Cody Garbazinski. Webster, oh. Now Dangerfield with the basketball, who's posting up on Charlie Oswald, and is fouled again. Dangerfield will go to the line for 2 as Robbie Young is set to enter the game for Charlie Oswald, who will have to exit with foul trouble with 5:41 left in this second period. And Dangerfield puts it in. And now Cowell is set to enter the game for the Wildcats as Dangerfield makes his second free throw. Cowell comes in for Tutler as the Wildcats set up their press. Kelly inbounds to Garbazinski and back to Kelly. As Kelly's bringing the ball up the floor on Moran. Josh Brewer will pull up for 3. And he misses it. Josh Brewer's really struggling to find his stroke as Cody Garbazinski is fouled on the putback by Dangerfield. That would be Dangerfield's second foul. And we'll see if Battleground Academy can afford to take him out of the game as he's played very well and been a very big presence down low for them. Garbazinski puts in his first free throw of the game. And he makes the second as Mayberry will come in for Dangerfield. They had to pull him with 2 fouls. Now both starting centers for each team has been put into foul trouble. Moran is bringing the ball up to 4. Giving it to Mayberry and then to Webster. And then back to Cowell and then to Shelnut. These Wildcats like to move the ball. Back to Shelnut, back to Mayberry, and then to Cowell. Shelnut driving on McDowell. And Cowell will put up a 3 from the corner, and he couldn't put it in, and as Webster knocks it out of bounds. It is Brothers basketball. Tutler will enter the game for Mayberry. And the Brothers will throw the ball in. Have to take a timeout as they couldn't get the ball in on this Wildcats press. That is the Brothers' first timeout of the quarter and first of the half with 4:50 left in this second quarter and are down 1. This is not the ideal situation for the Brothers, but sure they will come back from it. And we're back here at Christian Brothers High School. As Connor Kelly set to inbounds, this Wildcat press has been very effective on the Brothers as Cody Garbazinski rebounds and throws it back to Kelly. Kelly, dangerous cross-court pass Cody Garbazinski, who misses the 3. As Moran just tries to dribble, falls, and tries to recover. Tries to dribble the basketball They call a timeout. We'll be right back here at Christian Brothers Sports Network. We are back here at Christian Brothers High School as the Wildcats lead the Purple Wave with 4:29 left in this half. The Brothers, once leading this game, have struggled from the field and had a few defensive lapses. Cody Garbazinski is guarding Moran. As Moran puts up a contested jump shot off the backboard and misses. Robbie Young with the rebound. Connor Kelly will bring it down the court. Robbie Young now controlling the basketball and gives it to Josh Brewer, who throws it out. Garbazinski drives the lane and is stripped. And they said it bounced off his knee, and it will be battleground basketball. Moran brings the ball up the floor and gives it to Shelnut, to Webster. To Brown. Brown looking for somebody to pass it to. Gives it to Webster. And Webster forces a very contested shot on Josh Brewer, who played very great defense there. And now McDowell in the corner to Brewer. To Robbie Young, who pump fakes and is fouled. Great pump fake there from Robbie Young to get the foul called. That is Cowley's first foul as number 54, Taylor, will set to come in for the Brothers. Robbie Young makes his first free throw. Webster comes out of the game for the Wildcats. Robbie Young is a 42% free throw shooter on the year, so it's nice to see him on track from the free throw line. He rattles out the second one. The Brothers have Dineka, McDowell, Brewer, Young, and Garbazinski in right now. Harrison Dineka playing very well for the JV team. Now seeing important crunch time basketball for the Brothers. As Brown is running the show. Gives it to Taylor, who gives it to Moran. Back to Brown. Robbie Young playing great defense out on the perimeter on Taylor. As Brown continues to run the show for the Wildcats. To Moran, who drives the lane on Garbazinski, but Garbazinski's called for a foul. Garbazinski's about a head taller than his man is, which is causing problems for him. Moran is very quick and causing problems to Brown. Back to Moran, who puts up a three, and he puts it in, giving the Wildcats a three-point lead with 2:35 left in this first half. Dineka throws it in to Cody Garbazinski. Garbazinski having trouble bringing the ball up the floor on this press. Throws it to Young, who gives it to Brewer, bobbles it a bit, and a foul is called on the Wildcats. Taylor is called for the foul. Tutler enters the game for Taylor. Garbazinski inbounds it to McDowell, who gives it to Young. Oh, and he throws it straight to Cowley. Oh, and he missed the block. It is now 21-16 with 2 minutes left as Brewer brings the ball off the floor. Brewer has not been hitting his shots but played very great defense as he penetrates the lane and leaves another layup short. Wildcats are out running. Shelnut gives it off to Moran, who is fouled by Dineka. Moran will shoot two. As he puts the first one in, Connor Kelly enters for Robbie Young, and Cleveland enters for Shelnut. Seems to be a little confusion. The ref sorted it out, and we'll shoot this second free throw here. Moran puts it in. Kelly inbounds it to McDowell. McDowell right back to Kelly, who will take on Moran again. Kelly finally gets it across half court and gives it to Boer, who throws it out of bounds. More miscommunication from the brothers this. Palmy will be set to check in as Shelnut enters for Cleveland. Kelly bringing it up for the Wildcats. Gives it to Shelnut, then to Brown, and then to Tutler. Tutler back with the ball in the corner for three. Nope, Shelnut misses. DeBoer, who's off and running, and he is fouled. Looks to shoot two free throws. Josh Boer is clearly frustrated here and is having trouble finding his shot. Boer goes to the line for two. As he rims out the first one, Josh Boer is having a tough time finding the net tonight. As Matthew Palmy enters for Harrison Denica. Josh Boer puts it in. Hopefully that will boost his confidence in it. Moran bringing the ball up for the Wildcats. Gives it to Mayberry, to Brown. Brown back to Moran, who has played very well for these Wildcats this quarter. Gives it to Shelnut, who's guarded by McDowell. Back to, Brown fake Palmy right out of his shoes, but airballed the layup. Connor Kelly is bringing the ball up the floor. And to McDowell, and they throw it away again. CBHS bigs are begging the guards to slow it down on offense. As Moran brings it up the court on Cody Garbazinski. Mayberry guarded by Connor Kelly, throws it to Cowley, guarded by Boer. Brown has guarded by Palmy, looking for somebody to pass it to, gives it to Moran. Moran looking for a play from his bench, and he's got Cody Garbazinski on him. Drives to the basket, puts up a runner, puts it in off the glass with 4 seconds left. And, oh, Moran steals it. Tries to put in a pass from the – and that's the half. 25-17 Wildcats. The brothers are having a tough time here. We'll be right back here for Christian Brothers Sports Network with a little halftime recap. We'll be right back. And we are back here at Christian Brothers High School as the Brothers trail the Wildcats 25-17 here at halftime. The Brothers' key stats right now are the 11 turnovers, which are killing them. As the leading scorers for the Brother is Cody Garbazinski and Jake McDowell, both with four. As the Brothers continue to struggle with the turnovers, I think if they quit the turnovers, they could possibly come back into this game. Also, the leading scorer for the Wildcats is Andrew Cowley, who has five, who's playing very well and leading this Wildcats team. Charlie Oswald has entered into early foul trouble with two, as also Terrell Webster has three, as does Brian Dangerfield Brian Dangerfield has two for the Wildcats. And he's important as he's their center and most productive player. Again, we would like to say congratulations to the wrestlers as they have played very well this season and deserve the attention they're getting. We have Caleb Baker coming in first, Nick Gray in first, Brandon Hadaway in second, Luke Parrish in second, Corbin McColgan in second. So a great showing for the Brothers, as they played very well throughout the season and won the state dual tournament as they're going for the state individual championship. And it looks like we're about to start this half here at Christian Brothers High School. Hopefully the Brothers can get their offense back on track. The lineup for the start this half is the same as the starting lineups, with Charlie Oswald, Jake McDowell, Cody Garbazinski, Josh Boer, and Connor Kelly. As Cowley, Moran, Shelnut, and Dangerfield will start. As Moran with a good pass to Shelnut, who puts it in, as the Brothers are now down 10. Connor Kelly's bringing the ball up the floor. Gives it to Boer, and it's tipped. Brothers basketball. Connor Kelly will inbound. He gives it to Charlie Oswald, who gives it to Jake McGowell, who gives it to Connor Kelly, who puts in the easy lay-in. Moran now bringing the ball up the floor. Gives it to Cowley. Gives it to Tutler. Down to Dangerfield. Pulls a spin move. It's fouled by Oswald, and he puts it in for the and one. That is Charlie Oswald's third foul. Dangerfield will shoot his one shot, as he puts it off front rim, almost airballing it. Connor Kelly now bringing the ball up the floor, to stop. He picks up his dribble and is trapped. Tips it up, and Moran tips it up to Boer. Boer now driving into the lane, forces another one, and is fouled. Tutler will be called for the foul, as Josh Boer will shoot two shots here. He has stayed aggressive even though his shot is not falling. as he puts in that first free throw. And he puts in the second one. Moran will control the ball for the Wildcats. Tutler with the ball, guarded by Kelly. Gives it to Kelly. Back to Moran. He's really utilized his quickness on the bigger Cody Garbazinski. Moran puts up a contested leaner on Garbazinski, who takes it in and is fouled by Dangerfield, who will also be Dangerfield's third foul. Cleveland is set to enter the game for the Wildcats. As Cody Garbazinski shoots his first free throw, he misses. Cleveland enters the game for number five, Moran. Seems the Brothers and the Wildcats will keep their centers in with three fouls. As Cody Garbazinski puts in his second free throw. Cleveland will run the point for the Wildcats. Gives it to Tutler, gives it to Shelnut, who gives it to Cowley. Shelnut now with the basketball. Gives it back to Cleveland as the Wildcats are moving the ball very quickly to Tutler, but into Dangerfield, who's trying to force a foul and misses. Cody Garbazinski with the rebound. And now Connor Kelly will be bringing the ball up the floor. Gives it to Jake McDowell. Baseline jumper. Misses. Oh, almost got the offensive rebound, but Cleveland gets it. Throws it cross-court pass to Shelnut, who goes back into Dangerfield. Throws it out to Cleveland. Back to Dangerfield. Charlie Oswald playing great defense with three fouls. Connor Kelly throws it ahead to Boer, who could not get into the lane. Did not have numbers. Wisely chose to take it out to Connor Kelly. And now Cowley will be called for a foul on Jake McDowell. Connor Kelly will inbound as Moran and Brown into the game for Cleveland and Tutler. Charlie Oswald baseline jumper is good. The brothers really want to get Charlie Oswald going after he played very well against St. Benedict. The brothers are only down five now. Moran gets into the lane and throws a pass, and it's tipped by Charlie Oswald out of bounds Wildcats basketball. Dangerfield now catches the inbound pass and throws it out to Shelnut. And Shelnut will fire a three and miss. Great rebound there by Cody Garbazinski. Connor Kelly throws it ahead to McDowell, who drives the lane and puts in the layup. Great, great drive by Jake McDowell as the Wildcats call a timeout. The brothers have fought their way back into this with a 7-0 run, combined with free throws and just great basketball. We'll be right back here at Christian Brothers High School. We are back here at Christian Brothers High School as the Battleground Academy Wildcats lead the Christian Brothers High School Purple Wave by three with 4 minutes and 50 seconds left in this half. as Cowley now controls it and throws it in to Taylor, who has subbed in for Dangerfield and puts it in off a nice on a nice move. Connor Kelly will bring the ball up the floor once again for the brothers. And he gives it to Boer. Boer drives into the lane. Oh, great drive by and finished by Boer. Really getting going here in the second half. Moran fires it into Taylor again. And he and one over Charlie Oswald. That's his fourth foul. He's going to have to come out here. Robbie Young set to check in for Oswald. That is his fourth foul. Taylor makes his free throw. Connor Kelly inbounds it to Cody Garbazinski. As he is fouled by Shelnut, Connor Kelly will inbound. Kelly inbounds to McDowell. McDowell uses the screen from Robbie Young, gives it to Boer, who will put up a three, and he puts it in. Boer has found his stroke here, and he's feeling it. Moran controlling, once again controlling the Wildcat offense. As Robbie Young is being a little too aggressive there on the post, trying to deny Taylor any space. That is Robbie Young's first foul. Taylor up over Robbie Young and misses. Cody Garbazinski with the rebound. Garbazinski bringing the ball up the floor. Gives it to McDowell. Back to Cody Garbazinski. Cross court to Connor Kelly, who puts up the three and it's off. Robbie Young with the offensive rebound in between three Wildcats. The foul will be on Cowley as number four, Tutler, and Moran will enter for Brown and Cowley. We now have the two Morans on the floor, Tutler, Taylor, and Shelnut, with Robbie Young, McDowell, Garbazinski, Boer, and Kelly on the floor for the brothers. Connor Kelly drives, gives the Garbazinski, who gives it to McDowell, who gives it to Boer. Boer fires up a contested leaner and misses. Moran now with the ball, and he drives and misses. Connor Kelly with a tough rebound in between three or four Wildcats as he trips and falls. Luckily, Boer picks up the ball and gives it to Garbazinski. McDowell for three in the corner. Ah, it's long. Moran with the basketball as Connor Kelly's pressuring him. Moran now looking to drive on Garbazinski. Gives it in to Taylor, who's guarded by Robbie Young, who gets the and one. Great move by Taylor. Spins and is fouled. That is Robbie Young's second foul. As Webster. Webster and Herman are into the game for the Wildcats. As Taylor misses his free throw. Garbazinski will bring the ball up the floor. McDowell now at the top of the key as Boer hits the floor, and the Wildcats will be called for a foul. Now Matthew Palmy has entered the game for Connor Kelly. Garbazinski inbounds it to Robbie Young, who puts it in. A great play by the brothers there off the inbound. Robbie Young had a wide open layup there. As Shelnut, guarded by McGowell, gives it to Moran, then down to Herman. Great defense there by Palmy. And Moran turns it over. Robbie Young leading the break. Yes, wise decision to stop dribbling. Errant pass there by Garbazinski to Boer. Boer now controlling it and gives it to Garbazinski. Garbazinski is fouled by Shelnut. And the brothers are now in the bonus and will shoot a 1-1. Dangerfield and Moran will enter the game for the Wildcats for Moran and Tutler. The Wildcats now have Shelnut, Moran, Herman, Webster, and Dangerfield in, as the brothers have Palmy, Young, Garbazinski, Boer, and McDowell. Garbazinski makes his first free throw. And he puts in the second. The brothers have been struggling this game, but they really have done well from the free throw line. Only missing a few free throws. It's been integral in their comeback. As Moran fires up a deep three, and it is long as Robbie Young. Robbie Young has played very well for Charlie Oswald these last few minutes. He's had a few big boards and is setting some very hard screens out there. As Robbie Young pulls up for the jumper and puts it in. Robbie Young gives the brothers the lead with 57 seconds left. Robbie Young is not letting Dangerfield get any space down there as Moran is dribbling at the top of the key. As Shelnut now has it against McDowell. McDowell trip. And he's fouled by Palmy from behind. Probably a good move. He had a wide open shot as McDowell had tripped. Shelnut will shoot two. Shelnut misses his first. For all you Memphis Tiger fans out there, we just got word. It is half. At the half, Memphis is leading the Marshall Thundering Herd 43-26. As Shelnut makes his second free throw to tie up the game with 40.5 seconds left. As Cleveland enters the game for Shelnut. Wildcats have put their press back on the brothers as McDowell brings the ball up the floor. And Jake McDowell throws an errant pass to Josh Boer, who just couldn't get a good handle on the ball as it goes out of bounds. Shelnut enters back into the game for Cleveland as there's 30.8 left on the clock. Let's see if the Wildcats will try and hold the ball here for the last shot. Shelnut now at the top of the key, holding the ball with 15 seconds left. Number 4, Tutler, now has it against Palmy. As Shelnut comes around the screen looking for a shot with 1 second left. He airballed it. It is now tied 37-37 going into this fourth quarter. We have a tight game here at Christian Brothers High School. We'll be right back here at Christian Brothers Sports Network. And we are back here at Christian Brothers High School. It was just announced that the brothers have won the state individual championship. That is big for the brothers. Congrats to all of them on their hard work and dedication throughout the season. All right, as we're back here, as Connor Kelly brings up the ball, gives it to Oswald. Spin move. Oh, and he just couldn't get it. Oh, Charlie Oswald, a little too aggressive going for the rebound, and I think that's his fifth foul. He is now fouled out of the game. Robbie Young will enter the game. Robbie Young has played well this game, but he does look a little winded out there. Moran will bring the ball up on Garbazinski. To Tutler, to Cowley. To Shelnut, who will fire a deep three. Down to Dangerfield, who dribbles around. Little pull up. Oh, and Cody Garbazinski could not get his hand on the ball as... Again, two offensive rebounds and two missed putbacks from the Wildcats. As Robbie Young finally pulls down the rebound and gives it to Connor Kelly. Connor Kelly running the show for the brothers gives it to Boer. Boer now giving it to McDowell out on the corner. McDowell attacking the rim. Pull up from the baseline, misses. Moran now bringing the ball up the floor. Oh, he's going quick. Little dump off to Dangerfield, who misses, and then Tutler with the rebound. Cross court to Boer, as Connor Kelly just couldn't get the pass. Threw it a little too far for Boer, and Boer just could not get it and tries to save it, but it rolls out of bounds. Wildcats basketball. Oh, they are calling it brothers basketball. It seems that Wildcat player tipped the ball as Boer for three, and he puts it in, giving the brothers the lead. Oh, and the Wildcats players and coaches are incensed, having to go back to their bench as they're looking for a referee to talk to. They are mad. Down. They seem to have calmed down after our discussion with the refs. Now there's a timeout for the Wildcats. The brothers are up three with 6:40 left in this fourth quarter. Up at Josh Boer three. We are back here at Christian Brothers High School. As it's Wildcats basketball for Josh Boer three, Moran is bringing the ball up the floor. Moran guarded by Garbazinski, throws it baseline to Shelnut, who is fouled on a layup attempt by Jake McDowell. Shelnut will go to the line 4-2. As Shelnut puts in the first one for the Wildcats. Shelnut misses his second free throw with Robbie Young with the rebound as Connor Kelly will bring the ball up to four. Connor Kelly drives baseline, throws it out to Garbazinski. Up top for a Boer three as he puts it in. Josh Boer is on fire here at Christian Brothers High School. Moran bringing up the ball, guarded by Garbazinski. Wildcats are looking to get something going as they are having a little trouble here this half with this Brothers defense being so intense. Led by Robbie Young, who's played very well now that Charlie Oswald has fouled out. Dangerfield now with the ball. Throws it to Garbazinski. Moran for three. Oh, and it's, oh, misses. Now Dangerfield drives and puts in a baseline floater over Josh Brewer. Garbazinski will bring the ball up for the Brothers. Gives it to Brewer. Brewer drives. And, oh, he makes the layup, but he's called for charging as Dangerfield's feet were set. Now there's a little moisture on the floor that will be cleaned up. Now Moran will bring the ball up the floor. Tutler now controlling the ball at the top of the key, gives it to Shelnut. Shelnut into Dangerfield. Pulls a spin move on Robbie Young, and he misses the lay-in. Robbie Young has played very great defense these last few minutes. McDowell drives the lane and is blocked by Dangerfield. Moran pulls up for three and misses. But Dangerfield with the rebound and misses the putback as Garbazinski is fouled by about three different Wildcats who are all going for that rebound. Mayberry will enter the game for Dangerfield as Cody Garbazinski shoots his first free throw. And he puts in the first. And Tutler comes out for the Wildcats. Garbazinski puts in the second, shooting very well from the free throw line, only missed one in six attempts. Garbazinski now guarding Moran, who gives the ball to Shelnut, who drives and kicks out to Mayberry. Garbazinski now again guarding Moran, who he's held scoreless this half down. Out to Cowley, drives baseline and throws it off some Brothers' hands and out of bounds. Wildcats basketball with 4:40 left in this quarter. Cody Garbazinski now again guarding Moran at the top of the key. And Taylor pulls a spin move on Robbie Young, having trouble getting around him, forces up a shot, misses. Cowley with the rebound, though, and the made mid-range jumper. Cody Garbazinski now throwing in the basketball. Gives it to Josh Brewer. Josh Brewer now bringing the splits, about three defenders, spin move, forced up a layup. Oh, but he misses, and now jump ball. It is Wildcats basketball. Moran will bring the ball up the floor. Moran to Mayberry. Mayberry to Cowley. Josh, oh, into Taylor. Oh, who no-look passes, but they call 3 seconds on Taylor. That was a good pass, but he's just called for 3 seconds as Webster enters for Taylor. The Brothers will inbound on this tough Wildcats press that has not been as effective this half as it was in the first. The Brothers lead is three with 3:40 left in this first half. As Josh Brewer receives the ball at the top of the key, drives. Oh, and just couldn't lay it in. As Robbie Young knocks it out of bounds, trying to go for offensive rebound. Harrison Denica enters the game for Robbie Young. Robbie Young deserves all the praise he just got from this Christian Brothers crowd as he's played very well in replacing Charlie Oswald. Moran brings the ball up the floor. Penetrates the lane. Oh, and it's blocked by Cody Garbazinski. Great defensive play there by Garbazinski. Cowley receives the ball, gives it to Shelnut. And Moran is fouled, going hard to the basket. Moran will go from the line for two. He makes the first. And he makes the second one. Cleveland will enter the game for... Connor Kelly inbounds the ball to Jake McDowell. Back to Connor Kelly. Connor Kelly throws it out to Josh Brewer, who's jumping up and down, wanting the ball. Drives in and puts in the way in to give the Brothers a three-point lead with 3 minutes left in this half. Now Mayberry controls it at the top of the key to Tutler, to Cowley. Timeout, Wildcats. We will be right back here at Christian Brothers Sports Network as the Brothers hold a three-point lead. We are back here at Christian Brothers High School. The Brothers lead by three with 2:49 left on the clock. Josh Brewer has led the charge here in the fourth quarter, playing very well. As Moran gives it to Dangerfield. Over to Mayberry. As they're looking to Cowley as Moran. Oh, Moran is blocked by Garbazinski. But the Wildcats get the rebound, give it to Dangerfield, who misses the easy. Oh, Robbie Young trying to go for the dunk there, but comes up a little short, but makes it anyways. As Dangerfield looks like he's hobbling a little bit. Looks like he may have injured his ankle as Jake McDowell is called for a foul on Shelnut. The Brothers lead by five with 2:17 left in this fourth period. As Shelnut will miss his first free throw. As Tutler and Webster enter the game for Dangerfield and Cowley. Oh, the Brothers have called a timeout. We will be right back here at Christian Brothers High School as the brothers lead by five. We are back here at Christian Brothers High School. Coming off a timeout by the brothers. Shelnut will shoot his second free throw as the brothers lead by five. Shelnut makes the second. As Connor Kelly will throw in the inbounds to McDowell, who throws it down court to Josh Brewer, who misses the lay-in. As a foul is called on the going for the rebound on Cutler, as it looks like Harrison Denica will shoot free throws as the brothers are now in the double bonus. Now Callie and Mayberry will enter the game for Cleveland and Cutler. Harrison Denica is at the free throw line. Makes the first. Denica is one of the best free throw shooters on the brothers team, shooting 79% on the season as he makes the second. Moran down court to Mayberry, who gives it up to Cowley, who will drive on Denica and makes the lay-in. 51-47, brothers. Oh, Connor Kelly throws it down court to Jake McDowell as he is fouled. He had the easy lay-in, and Mayberry fouled him. Great, great pass and great court vision there by Connor Kelly to get it down court to McDowell as the Wildcats were pressing. McDowell to the free throw line. He is a 65% free throw shooter on the year. As he makes the first one. The brothers have shot very well from the free throw line this game. As he barely misses the second. Moran driving to the basket on Garbazinski. Kicks out to Mayberry in the corner for three, and he misses a little long. Cody Garbazinski with the big rebound. Connor Kelly again down the court pass to a wide-open Harrison Denica, who is immediately swarmed by Wildcat defenders. And down to Cody Garbazinski and back up to Connor Kelly to set up the offense. Garbazinski now with the ball. Over to Connor Kelly, who picks up his dribble and gives it to Brewer. Brewer drives in the lane, bobbles the ball a bit, falls down, but gets it out to Connor Kelly before he can get called for anything. And now Moran will be called for a foul. Connor Kelly, this is his first trip to the free throw line this game. He is a 66% free throw shooter on the year. He makes the first. And puts in the second. Brothers, again, shooting great from the free throw line. As Moran again misses a three over Cody Garbazinski, and Brewer with the rebound. And down court to Harrison Denica, who will throw a pass to Cody Garbazinski in the corner. Timeout, Brothers, as Cody Garbazinski had nowhere to go. The Brothers are up 7 with 55 seconds left here in the fourth quarter, playing very well. We will be right back here at Christian Brothers Sports Network. We are back here at Christian Brothers High School as the Brothers lead by 7 with 55 seconds left. Jake McDowell will inbound the ball for the Brothers. It's Jake McDowell, Harrison Denica, Josh Boer, and Cody Garbazinski and Connor Kelly are in for the Brothers as Harrison Denica is fouled. Harrison Denica will shoot two as the Brothers are in the double bonus. The Wildcats have in Moran, Shelnut, Tutler, Cleveland, and Herman. Harrison Indica puts in the first. Cowell and Mayberry will end the game for Cleveland and Tutler. Brown is in, not Herman. Number 14, Brown. Harrison Denica makes the second one. Moran brings the ball up the floor and will shoot a very deep three and misses. Cody Garbazinski with the rebound. And it goes out of bounds. Wildcat basketball. Cowley drives on Harrison Denica and puts it in. As there is a timeout. We'll be right back here, Christian Brothers Sports Network. We are back here at Christian Brothers High School as Connor Kelly is set to inbound the ball for the Brothers. Up 7 with 38 seconds left. Connor Kelly inbounds it to Denica, who is fouled by Webster and will shoot two free throws. He puts in the first. Denica is a very good free throw shooter. As Cowley Moran and Mayberry enter the game for the Wildcats. Seems they are going offense, defense here. Using their better offensive players and taking them out so their great defensive players can play as Denica misses his second. And that's Shelnut for a very deep three, but Brown gets the rebound and puts it back in very quickly. Now Boer is trapped in the corner and fouled and will shoot two. Josh Boer misses his first free throw. But he does put in a second to give the brothers a 7-point lead with 25 seconds left here. Moran shoots a deep three. Oh, and he misses. McDowell with the rebound as McDowell is fouled. With 15 seconds left on the clock, McDowell will shoot two. But it looks like this game is all but over here, and the brothers will get a win and will advance to play the Father Ryan, very good Father Ryan team next week at Father Ryan. As Jake McDowell misses this first free throw. And he puts second in to give the brothers an 8-point lead. As Moran gives to Shelnut, who drives the lane and misses, but puts it right back up with 6 seconds left. And Connor Kelly will throw the ball down to Josh Boer, who puts in the layup with 1 second left to give the brothers an 8-point victory. And they will advance in the playoffs to play Father Ryan next Saturday at Father Ryan. A great game here. We'll be right back here at Christian Brothers Sports Network to give you a post-game recap. All right, we're back here at Christian Brothers Sports Network. The players of the game for these brothers had to be Josh Boer, who led the brothers in scoring, and Robbie Young, who has not played a very big role for the brothers this season, but did tonight as he had to replace Charlie Oswald, who's in foul trouble this whole game. He played very well, as did Josh Boer. The brothers will advance next Friday or next Saturday against Father Ryan, who they lost to earlier this season. And let's hope the brothers can play well next Saturday and advance again in the playoffs. So this is Jonah Jordan here at Christian Brothers Sports Network thanking the viewers. And we will hope we may see you next week. We may not. But thank you and good night.